Thank you for watching CTR TV. I'm Christy Olds with your 5 in 5. Get up to speed on 5 topics in 5 minutes. Another victory to report for CTR at the state capitol. Members helped defeat proposed new regulations related to the forms for dual agency and unrepresented persons. It would have removed the real estate industry's ability to comment on any proposed changes to those forms and instead give authority solely to the commissioner of the Department of Consumer Protection. CTR General Counsel Jim Heckman says that proposal was too far-reaching.
CTR believed that the proposed regulation gave too much authority to the Department of Consumer Protection without allowing for input from the association and our members who use the form every day.
The Regulations Review Committee was considering that proposal. The legislative session is quickly coming to a close. It ends in less than 2 weeks, but anything can happen, including measures that could harm the real estate industry. Watch for any alerts from CTR about action we may need you to take. If you haven't already, text CTR to 52886 to sign up for text or electronically recorded messages on important legislative issues. While the legislative season is wrapping up, the election season is just getting started. CTR TV will keep you up to date on the issues, the candidates, and their positions that impact the real estate industry. We will have a pop-up studio at both the Republican Convention on May 12th and the Democratic Convention on May 19th. We'll provide updates and interviews throughout the day on our YouTube channel, as well as our Facebook and Twitter pages. Follow us to get the news as it's happening. Also, mark your calendar for CTR's upcoming primary candidate debates. The Republican gubernatorial debate is on June 5th. The Democratic debate is on June 11th. Tickets are limited. Go to ctrealtors.com/debates to reserve yours today. NAR recently issued a spam alert after members received emails that appeared to come from them. The suspicious email contains an alleged annual report, but it does not come from NAR and should be deleted. Another fraudulent email relates to RPAC and appears to come from NAR President Elizabeth Mendenhall. Members in Connecticut also received emails from fake CTR accounts. We'd like to remind all members to check the email address of the sender. Don't click on links or download documents you aren't expecting, and never send any personal information by email unless you verify its authenticity by contacting the sender using known contact information. CTR recently honored a student in the UConn School for Real Estate with a scholarship. Stephanie Mall of Bristol received the CT Realtors Past President's Scholarship during the annual awards banquet on UConn's campus. Stephanie will start her senior year at UConn this fall. She's majoring in real estate and urban economics and says real estate and law are longtime interests. CTR Past President Deb Chamberlain presented the $1,000 scholarship.
I think real estate is now the go-to career. It's not the fallback career. It's not just something we do. It's actually a choice. These kids are making a choice. They're smart. They have economics backgrounds. They speak multiple languages.
It just solidifies me going into the real estate career, and that if I put my mind to it, I can achieve anything I'd like.
A selection committee of CTR past presidents awards that scholarship each spring to a student in the UConn School for Real Estate who is pursuing a career in the real estate industry. CTR offered a sweet treat to lawmakers, staff, and the public who recently visited the state capitol. The association hosted its annual ice cream social. The casual gathering gives CTR leaders a chance to meet with legislators and staff. Hundreds of people stopped by for a little ice cream and to learn a little about pending issues important to real estate in Connecticut.
The best part of today is relationship building. We need to build relationships with people that help shape the future of the state of Connecticut. And that's what we've been doing today, and hopefully having fun at the same time while we're doing it.
The Ice Cream Social is a popular event at the state capitol. That is your 5 in 5. I'm Christy Olds for CTR TV.